When you are working with large number of tags, you might love to provide read more or read less functionality to your website. This feature is pretty common in almost every modern website. Therefore, in this video, we'll learn how can you automatically add read more or read less functionality based on the number or size of content. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jit Saru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. Okay, this is the code that I have taken from my old video. In that video, we did create our skeleton loader. So with the help of LiveServer extension, let's check out result in our browser. Okay, as you can see in our browser, you won't be able to see that skeleton loader. It's because all the images, they are stored within our local machine. So because of that, it won't take much more time to load. So let's change our network speed. I'm giving slow 3G. Now once again, if I refresh my page, did you see that? Now you will be able to get that skeleton loader. And my profile picture, it took much more time to load. So within that time, you'll be able to see that skeleton loader. Did you see that? It took almost 19 seconds. So for our source of image, I just want to give direct link. For that, I just want to copy the link of this image. And let's paste it there. And also for our profile image, I'm going to use this image. Once again, let's copy the link and paste it down there. Now in our browser, did you see that? In order to get that skeleton loader, I don't need to change that network speed to slow 3G. By the way, I have already created a separate video on this topic, and also source code will be given in the description below. Right now, I'm feeling something is wrong with this design, so I'm just gonna update some codes. So I have given different timestamps, with the help of which you can jump to a specific part of video. And once again in our browser, you can see everything is messed up. So for our class card banner, let's keep margin of 0 as well. And also we don't need this width. Instead for the height, let's keep 200 pixels. Okay, this is fine for me. And also you can see for the class card image, although I have given border radius of 50%, in your browser you won't be able to see that circular shape. So let's keep overflow of hidden. And along with that, let's keep margin top and bottom to 0.5 rem, and for the left and right, 0. Now we are going to apply read more or read less, or you can call it see more or see less functionality to our multiple paragraphs. For that, we need to create see more button. So just below the div with class name card description, let's create another div with class name see more btn. And within that div, I'm creating strong tag, and within that, I'm writing see more. And next to that, let's create a span tag with class name arrow, and within that I am writing ampersand has 709 semicolon. So with the help of this code, you'll be able to get that down pointing arrow. It's not best practice to give icons, but it's our small project, so it doesn't matter. Now let's give some CSS code for this class see more button and arrow. For the class see more button, which is within the div with class name card, I'm giving padding top and bottom to 1 rem, for the left and right to 0. Similarly, for the text color, I'm giving this red CSS variable. You can see at the top, I have already declared that CSS variable. And also, let's give text align to center. And initially, for the filter brightness, I'm giving 100%. But now you can duplicate the same code and bring it down there. And when you hover that see more button, at the time we'll change this filter brightness to 80%. And also I want to change that scale as well. Let's give 1.1. But in your browser, you can see when you take your mouse near to that see more button, you won't be able to get that smooth transition. So for our see more button, let's give transition of 0.4 second. And now you can copy same class. And now let's change that arrow shape and size. Okay, for that, for our class arrow, let's give scale x-axis to 1.8, and for our y-axis we'll keep it normal value. But you can see in our browser you won't be able to see any changes. It's because it's an inline element. So let's give display inline to block. Now in your browser you can see this is the exact size that I want. Similarly, I want to give some gap between that text and icon. For that, let's give margin left of 0.5 rem. Okay, this is exactly what I want. Now you can see although we have multiple line of text and all those texts, they are passed down within the DBT class name card description, and all that was done with the help of JavaScript code. So I just want to add more text so that you will be able to see more content within our card description, and this is actually the number of words that I want. And now it's time to give that linear gradient foreground call. For that, for our class card description, let's give the before pseudo element. I'm giving position of absolute. So now we'll give position of related to its parent. And also, let's give content to empty string. It's necessary to give that, otherwise you won't be able to create that before pseudo element. And for the width and height, let's give 100%. That means it will take the whole width and height of its parent. And for the background image, let's give linear gradient column. For the direction, I'm giving two bottom. And for the first color, let's give this transparent. And for the second color, I'm just giving white color. So our card's background color, that is the white color, so I'm giving their white color. I think I have already declared that CSS variable, and also you can see for the class card I have given the same background color, so it's better to use that variable. So let's give that variable name white, and let's wrap it within the var function in your browser. Did you see that? Now you'll be able to get that linear foreground color. And now for the DBT class name card description, I'm giving extract class name remove gradient color. So you can copy the same class name, and I just want to duplicate this code. Now whenever you are giving that class remove gradient color for our DBT class name card description, at that time for our before pseudo element, let's keep opacity to 0. And you can duplicate the same opacity code and bring it down to that before pseudo element. And initially, we'll give our opacity to 1, and we are changing our opacity value. So in order to keep that smooth transition, let's give transition duration of 0.8 second. And also you can copy the same code and paste it down there. And I'm giving there plus. Just after the DBT class name card description, that dips next sibling element, that is the DBT class name Seymour button. So we are just trying to select that DBT class name Seymour button. So you can just copy that code and paste it there. What am I trying to do is that whenever you are giving class remove gradient color for our DBT class name card description, at that time I just want to give a specific CSS code for our class arrow. So let's give rotate to 180 degree. Now you'll be able to see that pointing up arrow icon. That's because for our DBT class name card description, we have given their extra class name remove gradient color. So because of that, you will be able to rotate that arrow icon as well as remove our linear foreground color. So what if I remove that class name? In your browser, did you see that? Once again, now you'll be able to get that linear foreground color as well as down arrow icon. So this is exactly what I want. So now you can see that everything is controlled with the help of that class name remove gradient color. But you can see now you will be able to get that each and every paragraph, I mean each and every lines of text, which is within our card description. So for the class card description, let's give specific height. I'm giving height of 80 pixels. Now you can see everything is overflowing. So in order to prevent that, let's give overflow to hidden. Okay, this was all about the CSS code. Now when you click that Seymour button, you have to show as well as hide that other multiple lines of text that is within our card description, and that will be done with the help of JavaScript code. So for that, now we need to select this DBT class name Seymour button. I'm creating constant variable Seymour button. I'm assigning document.queryDestructor. So let's select the DBT class name Seymour button, and now you can just take that variable, and as you can see when everything loads in our web page, I'm calling function named renderCard. So now within that renderCard function, at the bottom, let's give for the Seymour button, I'm giving dot style dot display is equal to block. And initially for our Seymour button, I just want to give display to none. So what am I doing? When our page is loading, at that time, I just want to hide that Seymour button, and as soon as when the page loads, we'll display our Seymour button. As you know, I have already shown you that with the help of that class name remove gradient color, we did control our gradient foreground color as well as that icon. So now, as you can see, I have already selected that DBT class name card description. So for the class card description, let's give dot class list dot remove. Now with the help of this remove method, you will be able to remove any kind of class name that you have gave for that DBT class name card description. So I just want to remove the class name remove gradient color. Now, when you click that see more button, you have to add as well as remove that gradient foreground color. So for that, for our see more button, we can give the event. For that, I'm giving dot add event listener. So we are listening to the click event, and within that function, once again, you can take the same code and just bring it down there. Now, instead of that remove method, I'm just going to use toggle. So with the help of this toggle method, you'll be able to add and remove that class name, remove gradient color from the div with class name, card description. So once again, in our browser, did you see that? When you click that see more button, you'll be able to add and remove that gradient foreground color. So now whenever you are clicking that see more button at the time, let's change that text content to see less and vice versa. For that, within the same function, I'm writing this dot first element child dot text content equals to. So actually what does this means? This represents this see more button, and if you talk about that first element child, that represents the strong tag that is just above that arrow. So now we are just trying to change that see more text to see less. So once again, you can just copy this whole code and paste it there. I'm just using ternary operator. So for the condition, let's give if that text content that is equal to see more. Okay, you can give the question mark. So if that's true, then let's change it to see less. Otherwise, let's change it back to see more. So once again, in our browser, when you click that see more button, now you'll be able to change it to see less and vice versa. And along with that, you'll be able to rotate arrow icon as well. So initially, as you can see, for the class card description, we have given the height of 80 pixels. So now we need to change that value dynamically as well. So again, everything will be done with the help of JavaScript code. And once again, we'll take the same approach by using ternary operator. Therefore, I'm writing color description dot style dot height. So we are just trying to change that height of our card description. And once again, you can copy the same code and paste it there. And let's keep the condition. If our card description's height, if that is equal to empty string, then let's give card description dot scroll height. So now with the help of this code, you'll be able to get the total height of the card description. That will be the numeric value. But as you can see, this is the CSS code that we are giving with the help of JavaScript code. So I'm just adding extra string pixel. But if our condition is false at the time, we will change it back to empty string once again in our browser. But you can see you won't be able to get any kind of smooth transition. So for that, for our David class name card description, let's give transition duration of 0.4 second. Okay, now you'll be able to get that smooth transition. And also, I have noticed that when you take your mouse near to that see more button at the time, your cursor changes into text. So let's change it to pointing hand icon. For that, when you're hovering that class see more button at the time, let's change our cursor to pointer so that you will be able to get that pointing hand icon. And also, I want to change that margin value that I have given for our card image. Let's change that margin value to 0.8 rem. Now in our browser, you can see everything is working perfectly fine. Again, this is another problem. But what if you have just 2-3 lines of paragraph? In that case, this feature must automatically adapt it. I mean, based on the amount of content or size of content, we must know when to add this feature and when not to add this feature. As you can see in our JavaScript file, our render card function that is invoked when we are listening to onload event. So now within that render card function, so with the help of this code, we were able to hide our foreground color as well as show our see more button. Now within the same function, we can give condition. So for that, I'm giving if card description dot client height. So now this visible parts of card description, this is what I'm talking about, client height. If that is equal to card description dot scroll height. So with the help of this code, you'll be able to get the actual height. So now if that condition is true, then you can duplicate this same code and bring it up there. And now instead of removing that remove gradient color class, now we'll add and also we'll hide our see more button. And in the else part, you can take the same code. But right now you can see there are multiple lines of text, so you'll be able to get this functionality. So what if I remove this number of text? In your browser, did you see that? Our functionality is automatically added based on the number of content or the size of content that we have given for our card description. Just a moment ago, I have already told you that all these features that is totally depend upon this class name called remove gradient color. So why don't we use the same class for our condition? So now instead of giving these two different conditions, you can give the same condition. So you can just copy this code and paste it there. And now instead of that toggle method, you can give their contents. So now with the help of this method, it will return boolean value based on that class name remove gradient color. So if our card description contains that class name remove gradient color, we'll give our button to see less, otherwise see more. Again, we can use the same condition for our see more button as well. So in our browser, okay, now you won't be able to see that. It's because we just have two lines of paragraph. So now let's add more number of text. In your browser, did you see that? Our functionality is automatically added based on the number of content or the size of content that we have given for our card description. And everything is working perfectly fine. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already yet, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn, so keep learning.